afternoon, everyone. I'd just like to say thank you for all turning out. I have a dual hat on today as a daughter of a former member of the Liverpool Céilí Band and also as a committee member of the Ennis Trad Fest. This has been my personal baby and I couldn't wait for this. I'm sure going around the town all week, I've had people asking me, what time are the Liverpool on? What time are the Liverpool on? I grew up in Liverpool from the age of five. My dad played with the Liverpool. And I grew up with these guys, some of these guys. We are very, very, very lucky to have former members of the Liverpool Céilí Band. So we have Dan Barry, or Donald the Barra, who is currently in Limerick. We also have Mike Butler, who lives in Ennis, you all know Mike, who played with them. And for years growing up, I actually thought that Mick lived in Liverpool. He didn't. He lived in Surrey, down in the south of England, and he used to travel up to us, spend all weekend playing with the Liverpool, and he's the first person I met when I moved to Ennis, Mick Butler. So I'm really thrilled to have him. We also have the three sons of Eamon Coyne. We have Eamon, we have Terry on flute, and we have Mick Coyne. Okay, Mick lives in Ennis. And we're delighted to have them here. We also have Deirdre Hodge, the daughter of Kit Hodge, who was also a member of the Liverpool Céilí Band. And we have the daughters of Sean Mack, as we called him, band leader, and we have his son-in-law, Ray Rooney, who wrote this gorgeous book. Gorgeous. It arrived in the post to me about 2 weeks ago. A day of my life gone just looking at the photos and crying. So very, very proud of all you've done to bring back the Liverpool to Ennis. For those of you that are from or have been in Ennis and seen the music over the years, the Liverpool Céilí Band, just fondly called by most people the Liverpool, they played in Ennis. It was their second home. They were, I'm sure you'll all agree with me, a Liverpool Clare band, because all the tunes were from Clare. When I first moved over 27 years ago, I moved to Galway, and I went to the pubs, and I thought, I'll go to a session, and I thought, God, I don't know any of these tunes. Came down, Miriam Coyne, Mick's wife, presented me with a photo there, and I brought my daughter down here to come and play tunes. I knew Flynn was on, or, you know, something was on, and I'd come down and I'd play tunes. And I met Terry Coyne on the street, Eamon Coyne, and I thought, I'm home. I sat into a session, I knew every tune. I thought, this is it. So we'd like to welcome on part of the committee. I walked in and I said, lads, I'd really love to, they know I'm a Céilí Band freak. I said, I'd really love, there's a book being written by the Liverpool Céilí Band. The son of Sean Mack, our son-in-law Sean Mack, has written this book, and we want to get them together, and I'm wondering, can we put them on in Ennis, you know, for the Trad Fest this year, and what do you think? And the reply from the chairman, Blackie O'Connell, was, that's a no-brainer, Anita. They're coming. They're part of the Ennis fabric. So he said, go for it. So we're very proud to have all of that part of the music. And the scene here with the Liverpool was that anyone that was around, they'd call them up to play. Okay? That's where I met my partner, Seamus McMahon, all the McMahon family. Everybody you see here on the stage, they were invited up. Until last year, I remember saying, where was that? There used to be a jet club. I said, and I used to sit on the front of the stage swinging my legs and playing the whistle, small girl. And I said, we used to set dance in there. And I was taken for a little drive and brought into Madden's furniture. tears streaming, dancing on the floor, looking up at everything. That's where we had our childhood. That's where we learnt our tunes. My own father died this year, so you'll have to excuse the rambling. And I know Sean, Eamon, Daddy, Kit, Peggy, they're all here with us in spirit. And I'd really like you to give us a big Ennis welcome to Liverpool. Your man here. Mick Coyne, and actually Seamus McMahon, and John Ring, we're going to a festival. Are coming back from a piping festival 26 years ago in Cork. And they said, why haven't we got a festival for ordinary musicians? It doesn't have to be just pipers. So the Ennis Trad Fest was born 26 years ago this weekend, and it's always been in November. Lads, what would we be doing in the middle of November if we didn't have that conversation, if we didn't have those three men? And I'd just like to thank everybody on the committee in the Ennis Trad Fest, and we'll rock and roll now. Mick is going to say a few words as well. Thank you.
How are you, everyone? Welcome. It's very nice to have you all here. What am I supposed to be saying? Ray and Maura have written a book here about the spirit of the Reels, it's called. And really, the band and Ennis, they were sort of, they were gelled together. I can never remember not being in Ennis with my father playing in any year. It just happened to be a town that lended itself to the Liverpool. I think it was Clare, really, when we used to go to Kilmahill playing. Kilmahills are in there. But really, Ennis lended the whole Liverpool. I suppose it was the exuberance of playing. When we used to play, we'd just sit down and you'd see me, Dad, and Sean would be singing and having fun. And that's what it was all about. It was more fun than anything else, you know. I mean, it's just music. And it's music it's there to be entertaining, but entertaining for yourself as well. If you don't enjoy it while you're playing it, you know. Really, Ray and Maura, really, to put this tribute together, which hopefully over the books here, and I hope you'll all buy it. There's great memories in Kilmahill playing tune and Declan Max with Peggy, my dad. Peggy was the piano player, Peggy Peakin. She was a really big part of the band, although you only ever saw the side or the back of Peg, because piano players always playing there,
on the side.
But she was, Peggy was just full of jokes and fun. And then we had Liam Webster was another man. It was always just, you know, it was great fun being in the band. And then with Sean and my dad, it was good crack. They were friends for life, and I think that's the thing that I remember more than anything else. That I never actually saw them have an argument. They were always, you know, they were always chatting away, and they were always together. You know, and when we come back from Manchester after things, and the two of them in the car chatting all the way in the car, and they talk about everything. They were really, really good friends. Anyone I heard them play anyway knew they were one of a kind, the band. I want to say a special thanks anyway to Brendan McNamara, who was so supportive to Ray. This is Sean Mac's wife, really supportive to Ray and Maura. Brenda and my mum, they used to tell a lot of stories about me dad and Sean, that you could write another book on some of the stuff they got up to. And a lot of it to do with just going into pubs And I can remember them getting on a train. I think they said they used to get the train and up to Clare, and I think they stopped four or five times. They just got off. You could get off the train then and come on, and you didn't have to pay. Your ticket got you all the way in those days, but you could get on and off. And John, that's it. Just used to be a great pub here in this town. We're coming to that used to play. Yeah, and you get off. They get off the train and they spend the day just find a pub, go and play a few tunes and get back on. It could take them a couple of days to get to play. And not these guys, they were amazing friends. And I suppose the stories of them as a band as well. Everyone who ever played in the Liverpool Céilí Band, I think there's a great friendship in it. There was never any hassle or gripe and things you might get in other bands, they were always there just for the fun of playing the music and the tunes. And I think that's the memory that I have more than anything else. Every time you played, there was a bit of crack going on. There was a bit of fun, you know. They weren't doing it for money, because there was no money in those days playing for Céilí's, I tell you. But you know, they were doing it because it was just pure love, for the love of playing tunes or playing tunes together, and being friends more than anything else. So Ray and Maura, the time and effort of putting this book, I really want to say thanks so much. And I think it's a book that anyone who's interested in, not only in the Liverpool, but in just Céilí bands and how people are friends together and stick together, it's a book well worth having a look at anyway. And that's it. And we'll play a few tunes now, I suppose. But, yeah.
We're going to take you through a little journey over the next half hour of some sets of tunes, reels and jigs. I can actually remember playing this set in the Jet Club when I was probably about 15, 16, two and a half, yeah. And, you know, something like about 500 set dancers all going in the place, and you've got a sprung floor, just the most magical times to actually play the dancers and get the spirits of the reels through the music. So we're going to play you what we call the Christmas Eve set.